Yo, what's up guys, it's me, Paradox Gaming, here with a new Hypixel Skyblock video. In this video, we are going to be going over the patch notes for the Spooky Festival, Spooky Fishing, and Farming Event, and then looking at some of the items in the Farming Event in the game. Okay, so first of all, just a quick side note, hope you like the new intro if you are common viewers. If not, well, that is a brand new intro. And the song is going to be Subnautica, because I will be doing Subnautica more and more. So from now on, I will be having 3 videos a week still. 2 Subnautica videos each of the weekends, and a Minecraft video every Wednesday. So let's get straight into the first patch note. So first of all, let's go through the new Spooky Festival. Now this has been out a week or two, but the farming event only came out like 1 or 2 days ago as of recording this. So hope everybody has their costumes ready, because it's about to get spooky. So basically they are updating the Spooky Festival. This was for Halloween, that was a week ago now, so actually yeah, it's probably been out 2 weeks. They've added 6 new special spooky mobs, which you can get, you can find and in special areas during the Spooky Festival. So definitely, the idea is here to offer this similar time to candy ratio, regardless of the island you choose to participate in during the Spooky Festival. No matter what island you're on, you'll be getting the same amount of candy from these mobs. Also, since they only spawn in specific in-game hours of times, often you'll find yourself rotating between mobs more often than before. Hopefully this will add up to a more interesting experience, and basically you get extra loot. So basically more will spawn on hubs and more will spawn in mega hubs, because there's more players to split it round. But spooky mobs will have a much higher chance to drop these chests, which can give you some certain loot. There is then a mega bat which will randomly appear, and you can get items from the shop that points to it. There's a few new items, so there's one of them, and there's a new legendary talisman that costs about 5 mil worth of purple candy plus the talisman below. General changes as Spooky Festival point counter at the tab, and then they've added some bonus events that have well gone by now. So that is about it for the patch notes. However, we will potentially go through the wiki to look at the loot, but cut to the next wiki page. Okay, so next up we have Spooky Fishing. We shall go through all the items, as there's a slight update to Bazaar with all the main items that you get. So, next one's by Doctor. So, hello, we've recently been making some changes to Spooky Festival to celebrate the second Halloween festivities. So, basically, for an hour before and after and during the Spooky Festival, you can get these spooky creatures. Just like the winter event, you have the winter fishing. In this event, you have some spooky fishing. So there's some new unique items. There's a soul whip and deep sea orb. We will also see most of these later. Through changes, spooky bait, which was before useless, gave you a negative sea creature chance, which is not what you want. It now gives you positive during the time. There is also a water hydra head, now gives plus 1.8 sea creature chance. Scrub boots now give +1.5. Added a new announcement for Fearmonger arrival. Shredder is now easy to max out. Shredder is now a fishing weapon, which means it can have sword enchant, fix looting on fishing rods, and a few other things. Sea creatures are now immune to the AOTD ability, because some people are stream sniping others and then just AOTDing their other people's like sea creatures out of like off the island and into the void, losing them the sea creature and its drops. So yeah, that was not so good. Apart from that, let's get into the next post. Okay, so next up we have the new farmhouse build and farming event. So it was a community project that has finished, and it's been renamed to farmhouse. So this is the where the farm mansion is, and there's a new NPC called Jacob. Jacob has a farming contest every 3 skyblock days. 1 skyblock day is 20 minutes. Each event lasts 20 minutes, so basically I think you either have an hour between them or 40 minutes between them. I'm pretty sure it's 40 minutes, so you have 40 minutes, no festival, 20 minutes of festival. And during the upcoming contest, during the contest, you will have 3 different things that you can farm, and then it depends on, top 5, get gold, top 25, get bronze, and then I think it's changed, but I think it's top 60%, 20% and something. I think it might still be 60, 20, and 5, but you don't always get bronze. So yeah, that is interesting. But basically, whoever farms the most collection gets the ticket. So you get tickets in relation to your medal, and you'll also get the medal. Every 3 days, you can compete in 1 of 3 collections, so you can't compete in all of them. To participate in the contest, just collect 100 of that item. So player who collects the most So basically, whoever gets the most rewards. Then there is the items that we'll talk about in game, and then there's a transaction, so we'll also talk about in the game. Double drop stacking, because there is many items that impact it, we have rebalanced the double drop mechanics. All mechanics that increase double drops are now stack like positively. So essentially, plus 50% chance it will add to your plus 50% hidden double drop stat, which behaves like ferocity. So basically, it's a hidden stat. And then we have to compensate, we doubled the elephant pet perk to plus 60 and the monkey to plus 50. Auction house improvements. The AH will now remember your search setting when it closes. Settings will also reset after 20 minutes. There's a new button to reset them after you've reset them. Apart from the bin filter, that is the only one that stays the same, bin filter or auction, so that is nice. Also, some general changes, some Bless Reforge added cactus to the farm merchant, reshuffled bazaar, and added contributions requirements to bartenders' brewery to let people earn more perks. So that is this update. Now let's hop in game and look at some of the new items. Okay, so I am on my island, and as you can see, I have recently built a massive farm that is actually kind of annoying, because they are adding a ton of things that have been made to help you build a ton of farms. So, for example, we shall build a farm and see how quickly we can do it. But, first of all, let's get into a private lobby, and then we shall explain the bazaar and then new NPCs. So first of all, let's go back to the spooky event. So bazaar has been reshuffled so that all the slayer stuff and mythological have gone into combat, and oddities are more odd. You can have Jacob tickets, which you can sell, which we shall get to in a minute. And then you have spooky, so you have green candy, purple candy, ectoplasm, pumpkin guts, spooky shard, werewolf skins, and soul fragments, all of which can be either found in those chests I was talking about, or you can find them from spooky fishing like the last two. Now, if we go over to the new farmhouse, there is 2 new NPCs as I was talking about. You have the Jacob's farming contest, of which I can claim that because I haven't claimed that. So that is all that I have done, apart from the other 4 that I'd already claimed. And then in here you can see that there is a ton of new items. Infodirt wand, you can use places a dirt block for 1 coin. You can put this in the builder's wand, which is really useful. Prisma pumps water poured next to it. Hoe of greater tilling, we shall buy that now. Now we have baskets of seeds. Now I would really do with this, and I probably could have done it if I didn't buy the hoe of greater tilling, but we have it anyway. And then we have some axes that you can, so pumpkin dicer, cocoa chopper just used for cocoa beans, melon dice will gain extra XP and chance of getting more melons, same with pumpkins, and then mathematical hoe blueprint means you can have specialized hoe for each crops, but they are really expensive to upgrade, especially to the legendary one. Plus one farming cap level, so per each one you've won a gold medal, so top 5% collection in each collection, you will gain your one potential to your farming cap. Extra farming drops permanently is like a talisman thing, but I'm not 100% sure if you can reforge it. Anyway, so we need this basket of seeds, and then I should finally prove that building a farm is really easy, as shown by this time lapse. Actually, no, I probably won't do a time lapse because it can't even be that long. It'll take me like 30 seconds. I don't exactly know. So I shall see you guys then. Okay, so we're back to build a farm. So what I've just done is if you put this in the builder's one, then you can build this really easily. Now I could probably do with some more coins just to make sure you don't run out. But you're going to have to do it in two partitions because, for example, if I do this, you may not use a grand architect there and you want it too thick. So in this one, we're going to be doing a carrot farm just because we can. Now, it really doesn't matter for your coins. Like, it's not a ton of coins, but it's quite a lot. But yeah, we'll just do all of this, and then after this, you're going to have to manually do the thing in the middle because, yeah, game equals annoying. And I mean, you probably, if you only did one layer, you could do it all in one go, but like, because we need the water, we are going to have two layers. So that is that. But then what we can do is like, wait, no, I don't think anyone. But like, yeah, I think you'll just have to fill that in manually, but that shouldn't take too long. I would prefer not to suffocate. Okay, I just realised you can literally just do that, and then that fills it all in. So yeah, all that small amount of time was a total waste. Yay. Okay, so that once you've done that, that is your entire plane done. Then what you can do is you can go to the side and you go here. So what we are going to be doing is just, I know what you can do is 8 in between, but just for my aesthetic purposes, and yeah, I'm going to be doing it like 6 in between, which is totally inefficient, but I just want to do it like that. So then you can ideally not lag back, and then just, I think I'm going too fast. I think the game doesn't like me going at 500%. Either that or there's like glitchy blocks going on. I don't know. But anyway, then you just dig out trenches where you want your water. And then once you've done that, gone all the way to the end, leaving one, of course. Well, one side you want to leave, one you want to place your prismarine pump. Zoom. And then we go, not three, but I'm going to 6 over. If you want it to be efficient, do 8 over, but like, who needs to be efficient? And then you go zoom. So I shall see you once I've finished doing these. Okay, so I've redone my design again to 5x5, just because then it only has to be one till of the greater tilling, as I have that. Okay, so we should just demonstrate with a few rows, but of course this is the hoe of greater tilling. Now, because it does a 5x5, you can go at 500% speed and then just like deal with it. Because it does like a 5x5, it's a smart 5x5, so I hate this. But yeah, basically it allows you to go at 500% speed rather than whatever speed you were going at before. So yeah, you can literally just go like this. Okay, I did kind of, I'm very terrible. Give me just 1 second to patch this up. Okay, so I can't seem to quite go 500% speed, however I can go quite fast. So therefore I will be, that's annoying, give me just my hoe of great, that won't work. Back to the original rookie hoe. But yeah, you can't go quite that fast, but you can go, of course, almost 500% speed. So then you can just do this. And then for the final bit, you just do that. And then you have a perfectly tilled totally tilled row. Then after you've done that, what you can do is clear your inventory and then go to bazaar. That is not bazaar. And then you can just go to farming, carrots, buy instantly. And I have them in my super compactor. Amazing! Open that up, put them all in, and then just go, be gone, be gone, be gone, be gone, be gone. Seeds empty, great. And then you just have seeds planted for the entire row, and you didn't quite make it. I mean, come on. Fire back at you. Yes. There we go. And then you have your row of seeds are done. That is one row of carrots done. Now, of course, they do probably all need lighting. Definitely. But yeah, that is how to build a layer of farm. So yeah, that makes it really quick. So yeah, that is how to build a farm. So hopefully this helped you guys out, or at least gave you the info that you needed on this update. Apart from that, bye for now. See ya.